Hi guys, welcome to Techie DIY. In today's video, we'll be building and setting up the Genmitsu PROVerXL 4030 version 2 CNC router. This is a 3-axis desktop CNC machine with a working area of 400 by 300 millimeters. Key features include ball screws for reduced backlash, integrated closed loop stepper motors for increased accuracy and faster speeds, an aluminium and MDF table bed with slots and clamps for work holding, a 400 watt DC spindle motor with an EAR 11 collet, and a control box running Gerbil 1.1H firmware. The machine's Z axis uses linear rods, while the X and Y axes use wheeled carriages with offset nuts to adjust wheel tension. The machine was supplied in a single box and included tools, end mills, software on a USB stick, a height probe, an additional 65mm spindle holder, and a user manual. Now we're going to assemble the machine, starting with the XY axis base module. The first step is to align the rollers on either side of the base. This can be achieved by measuring from the back of the rollers to the frame on each side and comparing the two measurements. Then use the hex driver tool to move the rollers until they're aligned. Next, we'll mount the X axis gantry using M5 14mm screws from the hardware pack. The gantry slots into the roller assemblies and is then secured with M5 screws. Moving on, we install the Z-axis assembly using M5 16mm screws, spring washers and flat washers. It is mounted onto the X-axis roller using the access holes in the back plate to install the screws. Following this, the coupler is installed onto the X-axis ball screw shaft. The X-axis stepper motor shaft is then inserted into the coupler, and the stepper motor is secured with M4 12mm screws. The screws on the coupler are tightened, hex driver can be used to turn the ball screw to access the coupler screws. Next, the drag chain brackets are installed. X-axis bracket A is attached with M5 12mm screws, and X-axis bracket B to the back of the Z-axis assembly with M4 6mm screws. Then Y-axis bracket B is attached to the left-hand Y-axis roller assembly with M4 6mm screws, and Y-axis bracket A is attached with M5 12mm screws. Now we can wrangle the drag chains and cables into position and attach them to the brackets with M4 6mm screws. Moving on to the wiring, starting with the X-axis limit switch, followed by the Z-axis stepper motor, the two Y-axis stepper motors, Y-axis limit switch, X-axis stepper motor, the spindle motor, paying attention to the wire polarity, and the Z-axis limit switches. Next, check that the AC supply voltage is set correctly on the switch on the side of the control box. Following this, we can connect the cables to the control box. Finally, connect the power supply lead, the USB cable, and the height probe. Moving on to the software. First, let's install the USB COM port driver. Extract the files from the USB stick into a new directory. Run setup.exe and select the install button. To verify correct installation, open the device manager, plug in the USB cable, and you should see a USB serial CH340 device under ports, COM and LPT. Click on it to check its status. Next, we need software to send gcode to the machine and control its operations. The USB stick includes two options, Candle and UGS. Let's install UGS because it's the more advanced choice. Extract the UGS files. Then we can open UGS by navigating to the bin directory and running UGS platform 64.exe. In UGS, select Gerbil from the firmware drop-down list. Update the COM port and click on the connect button. UGS will display an alarm, which is a warning that the machine has not been homed. To proceed, select the toolbox tab and click on the home machine button. Homing uses limit switches to find the home position or zero point for the machine axes. Now that machine is homed, we can jog the axes. The feed rate is set to the maximum of 5000 mm per minute or 196 inches per minute. Next, let's test the machine with one of the example gcode files included on the USB stick. A V-bit is installed into the spindle collet. To set the Z-axis zero point, we'll use the height probe, beginning by measuring the touch plate's thickness, positioning it beneath the V-bit, and attaching the croc clip. Now in UGS, if the probe module isn't visible, it can be enabled under Window Plugins. In the Z-axis probe window, enter the touch plate thickness and click Initiate Probe. The probe operation zeroes the V-bit to the surface of the material. Now let's jog to the position where we want to start the job. Zero the Y-axis and the X-axis. To open a G-code file, click on File, then Open. Navigate to the test code directory on the USB stick, and then these gcode files end with a .tap file extension. Once the gcode is loaded, we can run it by clicking the send button.